Hello friends, welcome to Tech Talks Engineer channel. Today we will see DC power supply system in electrical substation. Primarily, we will see working applications and main components of DC supply system, that is battery bank, charger, and DCDB called as DC distribution board. So, let's start with applications of DC supply. DC supply system in electrical substation plays a very important role by keeping substations' brains on. Meaning, all modern numerical protection relays, closing tripping coils, alarms, hooters, indications, and communication devices are powered by DC. Also, some energy meters are powered by DC. Hence, DC supply system keeps all the protection, communication, control and measurement devices running in substation. Now let's see main components of DC supply system. First, battery bank. As we know, battery bank is required as a backup DC supply, in case AC supply fails, and hence AC to DC converter fails to supply. In such situation, battery bank continues to supply uninterrupted DC power. In a battery bank, individual battery cells are connected in series so as to get the required DC voltage. For example, if required voltage is 220 volt, and each battery cell is of 2 volt, then 110 battery cells are connected in series. Please note that this example is just to get an idea. Practically, battery bank calculations include other points such as ampere hour capacity, charging and discharging rate of battery set, boost charger current, etc. Here we can see three-step two-tier rack. Battery cells are placed one after other and are connected in series. At the end we can see cable connections. These cables are connected to battery charger and DCDB. Now let's talk about battery charger. Battery charger is nothing but AC to DC converter. And as name says, its function is to trickle charge the battery bank, and to supply DC power to the load. Trickle charging means charging a fully charged battery at a rate equal to its self-discharge rate, hence keeping the battery at its fully charged level. In normal condition, charger provides DC supply to the load and keeps trickle charging the battery bank. Battery bank provides DC supply to the load only in case battery charger breaks down or AC supply to the battery charger fails. So in normal condition it is the charger which supplies DC power to protection, communication, control and measurement devices in electrical substation and not the battery bank. Let's see components of battery charger. These are windows for ventilation. These are fitted at the top and bottom of the panel. Below that we can see indication lamps, such as phase indicators, DC bus indicators, and so on. Below indication lamps, we can see controller. Controller is an important component of battery charger. Controller monitors all the important and crucial parameters of the charger, such as input AC voltage and current, output DC voltage and current, battery voltage and current, load voltage and current. It gives alarm in case of AC mains failure, rectifier modules failure, battery low, DC leakage, insulation failure and tripping. It is used for communication purpose also. We can see DC earth leakage milliammeter, which shows DC leakage current. Next to that there is position knob. It is kept in position 1 for normal condition, that is when battery bank is in service, and in position 2 for emergency condition. That is, battery bank is not in service in order to get DC output at load terminal. Below that there is charger and nameplate. Now let's open battery charger panel. This is how it looks once opened. There are 7 numbers of rectifier modules fitted at the top. Function of rectifiers is to convert AC into DC. Below that there are 7 number of MCBs. These 7 MCBs are used to supply AC power to the 7 rectifier modules. Next to these there are other MCBs for panel illumination, utility socket, etc. There is a circuit breaker for AC mains 3-phase incoming. Red, yellow and blue wire can be noticed at the top of the circuit breaker. There are two breakers. One is DC output breaker for load, and other is for battery discharge for maintenance purpose. Below these circuit breakers we can see surge protection plug, for protection against switching surges, and seven numbers of PL relays. Next to the PL relays there is insulation monitoring sensor. It energizes relay when resistance value goes below the value selected on the dial. We can see different set points marked on the dial in kilo ohm. Also below that there is a dial for time delay setting. This sensor is used for protection against insulation failure. Next to the insulation monitoring sensor, we can see two contactors. These terminals are for incoming AC supply. And these are outgoing DC supply terminals for load connections. These terminals are extended to DCDB, that is DC distribution board. So we have seen that three-phase AC supply is given to the battery charger. And rectified DC, which is an output of the charger, is given to load and battery bank. In charged condition, this is how it looks. We can see 240 volt on each rectifier module. Also we can hear the sound of cooling fans. Now let's see DCDB, also called as DC distribution board. As name says, DCDB is used for distribution of DC power to different load points. Here we can see multi-cubicle DCDB. This particular DCDB is designed for two independent DC sources. Here two independent DC sources means two separate battery banks with two separate chargers. This portion of the panel is used for distribution of DC power supplied by source 1. This portion is used for distribution of DC power supplied by source 2. And this middle portion is used as a bus coupler. Here we can see for each sources, that is for source 1 there are 5 cubicle boxes, and similarly for source 2 there are 5 cubicle boxes. These are used as output points for different loads. That means on each source 5 different loads can be connected. These cubicles have 3 lamps for on, off, and trip indication, along with 2 pole MCCBs for isolating particular load in case of abnormality. Through cables DC goes to bus bar. From bus bar DC is distributed to different load points through their respective breakers. Similarly DC supplied by source 2 is distributed. In normal condition DC power is supplied to half of the load points by one source, rest half of the load points are supplied by source 2. And bus coupler is kept off. In case of fault on source 1, source 1 breaker gets tripped and bus coupler breaker is switched on, hence complete load is powered by source 2. Similarly in case of fault on source 2, source 2 breaker gets tripped and bus coupler breaker is switched on, hence complete load is powered by source 1. Now let's see components of DCDB. For source 1 DC supply, this is voltmeter and ammeter to measure voltage and current respectively. This is electronic hooter for alarm. The push button to silent hooter alarm. These are indication lamps for on, off, and trip indications. This is 3-pole MCCB called as molded case circuit breaker. This MCCB is used to cut off DC supply in case of any abnormality. These are protection relays. This is battery earth fault relay with 1 to 7 milliamperes range setting. Earth fault relay gives breaker trip command in case DC leakage current exceeds the set limit. These are under voltage and over voltage relays. These relays give breaker trip command in case DC voltage passes under voltage or over voltage set limit. Same components are used for source 2 DC supply. Let's see bus coupler portion of the DCDB. Similarly, here also we can see 4 indication lamps for on, off, trip and supply healthy indications. Along with 3-pole MCCB, if bus bar panel is opened, we can see bus bar mounted along with temperature sensor and space heaters to keep bus bar duct moisture free in humid weather conditions. So guys, this is about DC power supply system in electrical substation. Hope you like the video. If yes, please hit the like button and comment. Please subscribe for more videos. Please check the links in the description box. Thank you.